Welcome to another Monday Coffee. In this episode, we talk about JWM updates, new packaging model for Jira automation on cloud, exciting new features in Bitbucket. Then we look at events, followed by the article of the week about Jira and ChatGPT. And we'll close it all off with a bit of partner news. All of this coming in a second after this intro. Good morning, everyone. This is Biro.
And I'm Nikki from Appfire. Appfire helps teams collaborate more effectively with the apps that make work flow.
Well, thank you for joining us for another Monday Coffee episode. We have a packed week this week. So
a lot of important updates. So I'm going to scan through the improvements to Jira Work Management first. Jira Work Management has some new updates. They're launching a feature that lets you import projects directly from Asana into Jira. This means you can easily move your tasks and plans from one platform to the other, making it easier for teams to collaborate. And on top of that, Jira Work Management has also updated its mobile app for both iOS and Android to include the summary view, which lets you quickly check the status of your projects while you're on the go. And Jira Work Management team is also looking for feedback on their newest premium edition, so feel free to share your thoughts in the community post.
Moving from Asana to Jira, Work Management. That's awesome. Is there any synchronization between these two platforms or just migration? Is the feature just migration or is it synchronization?
I'm not really expert on this particular topic, but I do know that there is also a lot of plugin resolving synchronization between the platforms.
Yeah, I think that's important. Migrating from one platform to another is important as well. Hashtag we love Jira.
Oh, yes. Well, I have a really, really important update about the Jira automation. So everyone who is a Jira admin or just uses the Jira automation, you should be aware of this. Starting from November 1st, Jira Cloud Automation will introduce a new packaging model to make automation easier and more consistent for users. In the old system, any automation rule that ran counted towards your limit, whether it was successful or if it failed. Now, only successful rules runs will count for your subscription. The update will also separate limits for different Jira products rather than having a shared limit across all of them. This means you can better manage your automation usage for each specific Jira tool. Plus, the model also increases usage limits for free and standard plans, allowing you more room to grow your automation tasks. You can preview these changes in October to see how they will affect your usage and make changes if you need. Customers who might exceed their limits under the new model will be offered a 3-month premium free trial for more flexibility. So if you're using automation for Jira, have a look at the post so you get familiar with the new limits and make sure you leave the feedback in the comments as well.
It's interesting that they're going to a model where the unsuccessful triggers of automation don't count towards the requests, because I mean it makes a lot of sense, but me being a technical developer guy, I'm thinking, but you're still consuming some compute units by starting that that automation task even if it fails.
Yeah,
interesting decision.
Yeah, there are quite. I would definitely recommend reviewing all those limits, especially per Jira platform. Some platforms might have them lower than you would expect, like for example, Jira Work Management. So I already saw some comments. So definitely review. Make sure you comment if you have any feedback for this.
Yeah, make sure you don't run out of credits. We all been there, done that.
Well, I have a last update to the Atlassian products before we move to the event. Bitbucket Cloud is rolling out new features to improve scale, security, and compliance for enterprise teams. One of the biggest additions is the integration of Forge, Atlassian's app development platform. With Forge, you can create custom merge checks to meet the organization's specific needs, like, for example, no code merges on Friday after 5 p.m. that should be actually banned. Another major update is the use of AI in the text and code editors. AI will help summarize comments and even suggest changes during the code reviews, making the review process faster and more efficient. Bitbucket is also introducing unified user management, letting you manage Bitbucket, Jira, and Confluence users all from one place under Atlassian's admin. These changes will be available for new customers early in 2024 and existing ones late 2024. AI is coming to Bitbucket.
Everywhere.
Yes.
It's coming everywhere.
I saw the example. You can see it in the community post. Basically, what you can do is like write down whatever you actually want to say to the review, like just in a points, and then you can say make it empathetic, and then it writes like a longer, nicer message.
Right.
I was thinking I would.
Is it gonna come with some prompt templates?
Yeah, you can like select from the drop down, and it would just like rewrite for you. But then I was thinking, you know. I'm, for example, the person who likes to just go to the point. I don't like to read long sentences. So I would actually appreciate to then have an AI to translate it back to the points. It would be quite useful. Just an idea. Let's go to the events.
Interesting. Okay, I'm sure that we have a very exciting future ahead of us with AI and Atlassian. So now, before we get into the events segment this week, I wanted to highlight this webinar. Us at Appfire are running this week. It focuses on the necessary steps to migrate your Jira server instance to cloud or data center before Jira server reaches the end of support date, the dreaded end of support date. If your organization is looking to transition from Jira server, this session provides insights and tools to facilitate a smooth migration, especially concerning project portfolio data. This event is for Jira Server admins, PMO senior leaders, DevOps, SysOps senior leaders, and admins of PPM tools like Big Picture and Structure. You will learn about migration to cloud or data center and which is best for you. So if you're in the middle of or just starting to migrate from server, this session is a must. Check out all the details in the link provided. Right. As for events this week, we'll kick it all off with a webinar from Atlassian, Scaling Agile by Atlassian on September 19, dives into expanding agile practices beyond team levels with Jira Align. Brad Kramer, a senior solution engineer, will discuss connecting team tasks to business strategies, enhancing decision-making and fostering innovation. There's also a Q&A session post-presentation. So check it all out. Moving on to partner organized events, and we got a flood of events this week. So let's mention a couple. Next Generation of Atlassian Tools by Glintech is a webinar on Wednesday. Atlassian now offers more than just Jira. So explore new cloud capabilities tailored for diverse teams. Join Glintech and Atlassian to discover the latest tools and tips for boosting organizational productivity. And then Hertzum Enterprise Day in Chicago. This is happening this Thursday. So if you're in Chicago, prepare for the AI transformation at Hertzum Enterprise Day. Engage in discussions on AI trends and their impact on Agile, DevOps, and IT. Network and gain insights from industry leaders to drive innovation. And let's end this segment by mentioning a couple of ACE events from this week. JSM for non-technical teams in ACE Campinas, Brazil, happening today. Explore how JSM can streamline non-tech team organizations and optimize processes using Jira. Gain insights into a non-bureaucratic approach with the Atlassian Foundation. Then we have September ACE London, Script Runner on Tour. On Wednesday, join the Atlassian community event in London, experience the exciting Script Runner tour, and engage with the community at the new Adaptivist office. And that's about it for this week's events. Check out Goosely for everything. A lot of buzz, a lot of happening this week. It's exciting.
Ooh, that AI event by Hertzum looks interesting. I actually have an AI article of the week.
You do? Well, yeah. This is a nice segue.
Yeah, and it wasn't planned at all. Interesting. Well, let's have a look. Felipe Lucena wrote a detailed article on how to integrate ChatGPT with Jira Service Management to automate triaging tickets. By using AI for sorting tickets, companies can improve accuracy, make processes more efficient, and allow teams to focus on more important tasks. In the article, you can find the setup requirements, like configuring ChatGPT to analyze customer sentiment and issue type, and then return this information in JSON format for Jira to use. And also step-by-step guide for integration, including generating an OpenAI API key and configuring Jira settings through the JWM app. Costs for using ChatGPT for this are extremely low, with an estimated cost of just around $5.50 per month for 10,000 tickets triaged. AI in ticket management has a promising future, offering some streamlined and precise customer service. Really, really interesting use case. Definitely recommend everyone to have a look. I think you can save quite a bit of time and money by using AI to triage some of your Jira service management tickets.
Yeah, for sure. I think we'll see more and more of these articles and templates. And thanks to Felipe for providing this article for this week's article of the week. By the way, if you have really interesting articles like this on how to's with AI or just general tips, tricks, and best practices around Jira, Confluence, and so on, and you want it featured on article of the week, we do that as well. We don't just promote Atlassian's articles. So feel free to submit it. Link in the description. But yeah, really good article. I think we're going to see more and more of these AI-related tutorials, which is great. Also more apps on the marketplace, because I'm sure there are apps in the marketplace that can do something similar. Or,
you know, when is there going to be a lot of apps coming, AI apps coming to the Atlassian marketplace?
Tell us, Nikki.
After Code Guys, because Code Guys is focused on AI. We talked about it last week. So yes. I'm expecting, like, towards the end of the year, we are going to be trying a lot of AI focused apps.
Exciting times. Right, let's close it off with an exciting update from the partner realm. Austin-based Precipito has acquired Gurnet Consulting, a trusted Atlassian specialized management consulting firm, to strengthen its Atlassian capabilities in the northeast of USA and Canada. This move deepens Precipito's commitment to connecting enterprises and closing the gap between technology investment and realized value. Gurnet's expertise in enterprise agility solutions and successful track record will bolster Precipito's position as a market leader for Atlassian products and enterprise transformation. So congrats to both of the teams. Really good to see some more consolidation happening in the ecosystem. And yeah, that's it for this week.
Congratulations, really good news. Well, that's about it for this week. For you not to miss the latest and greatest from the Atlassian ecosystem and the universe, make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel, Monday Coffee by Appfire, and you can also find us on LinkedIn. We'll see you next week.
Bye.